Hello, friend. Here we are with Gate 64 today. Gate 64 is called the Gate of Confusion, and it's about before completion. So this will become apparent as we walk through this. So the 64th gate here is in the third quarter. That's what we are moving through right now. It actually sits in the head center. So accepting confusion is the key to realization. So if you see here, the 64 points down to the 47. 47 is all about realization. So confusion happens during the abstract process. The abstract process is the collective process that is on the abstract side. So we have the 64 down to the 57, over to the 11, the 56, 33, 13, 46, 29, 42, 53, 41, 30, 36, 35. So it's all about experience, having an experience. That's why we came here. We came here to have experiences. We're human. And that's the whole fun part of this entire process, is that we are having experiences while we are in our meat suit. So as this gate sits in the head center, there's a pressure to come to a realization. So remember, the head center and the root center, they are about pressure. There's a fuel there. Okay, so this is fueling the abstract process, and it's a pressure to come to a realization. However, confusion happens before completion. You're never going to understand or come to a realization as to why you're having the experience while you're in the experience. It's usually an afterthought. It's after the experience has happened. Again, when you look at the 33, 13, it's the channel of the prodigal, right? It's about witnessing. It's about seeing it, seeing the experience, retreating, taking time with self to see, okay, what just happened in that experience? Why did I go through that experience? So it's not going to happen before the completion. It's going to happen after the cycle is done. So meaning the confusion will come to a realization once the cycle has come to a close. Again, the experiential way is cyclical. It's moving us, you know, from one step to the other, from this new experience, this new contraction, this new focus that we can focus on. And then we get to expand out and experience self and discover self in this whole process. And then as we come to a close and a new cycle begins, then we can realize why that cycle happened. So in order to enjoy your mental state of confusion and not be overwhelmed by it, let the clips of your past experience simply stream through your mind until the message of the movie becomes clear to you. We can all do this. We, you know, for the most part, I shouldn't say all of us, depending on your state of health, I guess, we're able to, you know, have memories and go back and see those memories. They're like little movie clips. And look at them and go, oh, okay, now I know why they said that to me. Oh, I know why we had that conversation. Now I get why, you know, I had that accident. And it's just about a reflective process, really. So once the realization happens, then you get to share it with others. Our minds, again, are not for us. I know that, like, when I say that to people, they're like, what? But our minds are for everybody else, because our minds become a beautiful outer authority for other people. I'm not having your experience. You're not having my experience. However, I can enjoy the taste, the feeling, the touch. I can have all of these cognitive understandings and realizations in my body by listening to your experience. I can do that. So can you. So even though I'm not there, I could picture the whole thing when you're telling me. Like I had said in one of my other videos, I have no desire to skydive. Is there fear there? Probably. But it's not something that I want to walk through. It's not exciting for me. Yet when somebody else does it and they speak to me about their experience, I can enjoy that experience through their outer authority. Again, the mind is for the other person. It's not for you to make decisions from. It's strategy and authority. Trust the electromagnetic field of your body. Trust your own internal GPS, your own inner authority that will you know, move you to who you have to interact with. And then you come to a realization after that interaction has happened, after that experience took place, oh, okay, now I know why that happened. And then you get to share it. So what happens in the not self? Of course, anytime we have a gate that is not defined, the not self mind wants to chew on it. It wants to, you know, grasp onto it. And it wants to tell you that you need to work harder and get better at it. And design is saying, you know, flipping that right around 180 and saying, no, move from your strengths and never make decisions from the mind. So the not self, of course, will get lost in the confusion and will always chew on the past. And we see this in people who are just so attached to their victimized story that they can't move forward and just go, oh, okay, that happened. It was an experience. I've grokked the information from it, whether it be super traumatic or not. It's all about reflection to see, okay, how did I get there? What kind of decisions happened? What kind of, you know, was I thinking about fear constantly, all day long? You know, what was I thinking about? Thoughts are things. Thoughts are things. The universe only communicates in frequency and vibration. That's all it is communicating to us with. So if we're putting out a fearful thought, then fearful things are going to present themselves. It's the law of attraction. There's no law of repulsion. It's always the law of attraction. So again, the mind can get really lost and very so full of confusion that it's difficult for you to move through the confusion, and then you're trying to make decisions based off of the confusion when you're living out of the not self. Very scary place to be. And you know, if you take a moment and just look at our world, a lot of people are sitting in that completely confused and then trying to navigate based on the confusion. And design says, no, do not do that. Trust the strategy, trust the authority, and let your body navigate this plane from their its electromagnetic field. So again, this is who I am. This is my design. So if you ever want to, you know, connect with me, you know what you're connecting with. What I love is it's fun to watch how we, of course, bring to us the people that need our particular energy. And, you know, there's lots of interesting clients that pop up when you fully step into your true self. It's really quite fun. So if any of this intrigues you in any way, shape, or form, or you want to move forward in human design, these are all my contact places. Something else I'm looking at is doing a monthly study group as well, so that we can all connect and just walk through a bunch of stuff. All right. Thank you very much for your time, and talk to you soon.